Heather, the next couple of scheduled launch times are later in the day, and so let's talk about what that could mean.
Yeah, well, at a place like Cape Canaveral on Florida's Atlantic coast, the main weather concern is lightning, especially in the summer. I spoke with meteorologist Chris Vigasky, who does a lot of work with historical lightning data. He says that Florida sees about 14 million lightning strikes every year.
Lightning is a concern every day in the summertime in Florida, where you have interactions between the land and sea breezes. And every day you can kind of time your watch to it. You'll get a thunderstorm in the afternoon, thunderstorm in the late evening.
Askey says that as we go through the month of September, the threat for lightning drops slightly for the Florida coast as we lose the summertime heat that fuels those thunderstorms. And of course, NASA is well equipped to predict and detect lightning around the launch pads. You can see these strikes hitting towers surrounding Artemis 1 just this past Saturday. Actually, improvements in lightning research came after the Apollo 12 mission was struck by lightning twice immediately after launch.
That really started to get people thinking, okay, lightning is really a concern for these missions, so we really need to be better prepared for when lightning is possible and is there lightning in the area so that we don't have these incidents happen again.
And as a rule, a launch has to be delayed if there's a threat of lightning within 10 miles of a flight path. As you can imagine, that can really limit a launch window. So why does NASA use Cape Canaveral as its primary launch site? Well, for one, if something were to go wrong, it'll happen over a large body of water, the Atlantic Ocean, rather than over a populated area. But interestingly, fuel efficiency is part of it too. Rockets get an extra boost by using the fact that they're already moving on the ground because Earth is spinning around its axis. And the closer you get to the equator, the faster that Earth's surface is spinning. For example, here in Northern California, we're spinning at about 750 miles per hour, but farther south in Cape Canaveral, the ground is spinning at about 900 miles per hour. And every little bit counts because Artemis 1 has to reach 25,000 miles per hour to break away from Earth's gravity. Vigasky says that for now, weather conditions look favorable for the next potential launch window this Friday. Back to you.